I just do. I love seeing it up on the mantle. My dad didn't have a truck like that.
Isn't this adorable?
It's just so
pretty. It reminds me of...
Okay, listen, this is what you saw up on the mantle. Let me just scoot in a little bit closer because I'm going to take these off. Okay, so this is what you saw up on the mantle when Nancy and I were showing you those pumpkins.
Cute.
And you got a little peeky-boo at this truck. And I was like, it's coming up, you guys. This is new. It's the first day it's presented. And it's the Plow and Hearth Decorative Vintage Pickup Truck with Pumpkins. This is like a dream. This is what, you know, when the world was slower, calmer, where neighbors knew each other, mm-hmm. where people waved and said hello and helped you, you know, carry your groceries to the car. It was when milk was delivered to your front door. Do y'all remember that?
Right, in the glass bottles, and you got butter and eggs, too.
Yeah, you did.
It reminds me of that old, that town in the South where the sheriff, you know which one I'm thinking about?
Yeah, yeah.
And that's what it reminds me of, that, you know, sheriff and the funny deputy.
I like that. All right, we do have two choices, though. Mm-hmm. The one in front of me is what we're calling the ivory. And just so you know, I mean, it's completely beautiful from every single vantage point. Now that one is the ivory. Then in front of Nancy, she has the blue one.
Yes, exactly. Look at this. so this is that old fashioned truck, and it definitely is kind of like, you know, years gone by. Like you said, when the neighbors were bringing each other, you know, a pie because someone, you know, graduated from high school or something, and they were just getting all together for family gatherings. And this is made out of resin. Mm. And I love the pumpkins that are just, you know, the really large pumpkins that someone was so proud that they were able to grow. You've got real straw on here. So you're going to use these inside, or a covered porch would be okay. But not out in the direct elements.
Okay.
So I just think that this is adorable.
They're charming.
It's just such a cute piece. If someone has a small, you know, maybe a desk that they want to put something out on their desk, they don't want to go wild or crazy, but they'd love something for the season of autumn. This would be a great choice. Or maybe you have a guy who wanted to have a truck like this or collects trucks like this.
This is adorable. And it's so well detailed. I mean, there's the grate, the chrome grate. The almost smiling eyes that it gives you. You see a little bit of dirt and dust or pollen or paint job that could use a little fixing up.
Right.
By the way, the ivory is, what did you tell me, Frank, on the update? The ivory is the more popular option, but the blue is the more limited option. You guys really like this, and so make sure you don't miss out on it if you're just watching and you're not getting this going to your phone. They're about 11.5 inches by 6.5 inches, and they're just very vintage. They again remind us to slow it all down.
Mm-hmm.
And don't we wish we could?
I know.
A little bit.
I really liked it there as a centerpiece, too. That's so different. That's, you know, I like thinking out of the box. Mm-hmm. So if you're someone that wants to have something in your centerpiece, you know, if you're having a dinner, you're having some neighbors over, and, you know, it's not really Thanksgiving or anything, but it is fall. How about using something like this as your centerpiece and putting that those orange berries around, maybe putting some mums. And this is an adorable... Yeah. Centerpiece.
They will chuckle.
Here's what's nice. They'll chuckle, but also you can see over it. Because so many times, you know, centerpieces are kind of big and you really can't see it. I like that this has lots of charm, lots of personality, and something to talk about. People will talk. Maybe they'll start thinking about, you know what, I had a truck like that when I was growing up. And we went out and we gathered pumpkins, or we did a family trip and we, you know, all gathered in the back of the truck.
That's what I said when I started this presentation. I don't know why I love this. My dad didn't have this truck. We never had a truck like this. I don't even know why I love it. There's just something because of the way that Plow and Hearth did it.
Mm-hmm.
Remember what Nancy told me at the beginning of the show? She was like, Antoinella, you're really going to love this show because there's such real warmth and just a big nod to the very roots of Plow and Hearth.
Yes.
And this is one of the reasons. I have no reason to love a pickup truck, but I love this truck. And I think when you get it, you will too. It's really weird. Why?
Well, you know what else I think I love about this too is it's all done. You're gonna get this home. You don't have to add the pumpkins. You don't have to add the straw. You don't have to add a little bit of the distressing or anything. It's kind of on there, so it looks well loved.
So
it's just done perfectly. And Plow and Hearth is that company that's going to give you those pieces that are gonna help add that warmth and welcome to your home. Mm-hmm. They're going to give you those things that make it easy to decorate, but make it look like you put in a lot of effort. So there's kind of the magic, right?
Yeah.
Is to have something that looks spectacular, but nobody knew that it was actually really easy to do.
But there's the bottom. I mean, I just want you to see it from every angle. It's just fun. There's a textural feel to it too, with the genuine hay and the straw. You've got the gourds, and you have the big prize pumpkin on top. But when you peek into the flatbed, it's filled with more pumpkins. And it's just, I don't know. There's just something where you wish you could hop in it and go wherever they're going.
It's playing country music. That's what I think of.
Yeah.
Playing some country music. And
by the way, over 1,000 of these have been ordered. My line producer just called me Carolyn.
Really?
That's kind of awesome because Carolyn's a great host.
You're a great host too.
He's telling me it was an accident. Oh, now he called me Jane.